Today, we're talking about the C word, specifically kidney cancer. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and if you're new here, we talk about lots of things, urologic content, bladder health, sexual health, and much, much more. So if you want to learn, make sure you subscribe and share this channel with your friends. Today we're going to cover a lot of things about kidney cancer. What exactly is it? How common is it? What symptoms present with it? How is it diagnosed? And what are the treatment options? So starting off, what exactly is kidney cancer? Kidney cancer is essentially abnormal growths or tumors that occur in one or both of the kidneys. Everyone is typically born with two kidneys, one on each side in the back part of their abdomen, and they function to remove the excess waste in your body. So your blood filters through the kidneys every day to clean out any waste that's accumulated in your body. So who gets it and how common is it? Well, it's most common in people between the ages of 60 and 80 and more often seen in men. In the United States, we expect that about 2% of men and 1% of women will get kidney cancer during their lifetime. In fact, in 2022, we expect about 79,000 cases of kidney cancer and 13,000 deaths due to kidney cancer. Well, who gets kidney cancer? Well, we don't know exactly why it happens, but we do know there are some people who are at higher risk of getting kidney cancer than others. Those include people who smoke, who have very high blood pressure, who are obese, and who have certain exposures at work to things like cadmium, asbestos, or gasoline. We also know that people who develop lots and lots of cysts in their kidneys as adults are higher risk for getting kidney cancer. Certain genetic conditions also, which are listed here, can put you at higher risk of getting kidney cancers. Certain syndromes can also put you at higher risk of getting benign tumors like angiomyolipomas, which are a combination of blood vessels, muscles, and fat. While these in and of themselves in the small sizes are not dangerous, they can be dangerous if they increase in size or if you have multiple of them. And 80% of the time, these occur sporadically, whereas another 20 to 30% of the time, these are associated with a condition called tuberous sclerosis. So how do you know if you have kidney cancer? So in the textbook, they describe people who have kidney cancer to have three specific symptoms: blood in the urine, pain in the flank or back, and a mass, a palpable mass in the backside. However, that's only present about 10% of the time. More often than not, we're finding kidney cancers incidentally. What that means is that people are getting CAT scans for other reasons. They're going to the emergency room with abdominal pain, they're having constipation, kidney stones, whatever other reasons they're getting CAT scans for, and we're finding kidney tumors. However, even though we're finding them without the classic symptoms, about a third of the time they're metastatic, meaning that they've already spread to other parts of the body. So often when you've had metastatic disease, you may notice some symptoms: pain that comes and goes, having night sweats or unintentional weight loss, meaning you're losing weight but you're not really trying to, and a fever that comes and goes. So how do we ultimately diagnose kidney cancer? Well, we do a CAT scan or an MRI, which is an imaging test of the kidney. We look at without contrast and with contrast to see how it uptakes that contrast. If it takes a lot of contrast up, we have higher concerns for a cancerous lesion of the kidney. Also, often you'll get a chest x-ray because the most common place that kidney cancer spreads is to the lungs, as well as some blood work to see if there's other abnormalities that may be concerning, and to determine how well your kidneys are functioning at baseline. So how do we treat kidney cancer? Well, if you're found to have a tumor in the kidney, it depends on exactly how big that tumor is and overall how healthy you are. If you are very healthy, have good kidney function, and the tumor size is greater than 2 or 3 centimeters, very likely you'll then proceed to have surgical removal of either part or the entire kidney, depending on how big the tumor is. If, however, you're not very healthy and you have a lot of other comorbidities, or you have other medical conditions which might be causing you to have a mass in the kidney, like some hematologic conditions, other cancers, or inflammatory conditions, then we'll proceed with what's called a renal mass biopsy. Why don't we do a biopsy on everybody? Well, about 10 to 15% of the time, when you do a biopsy of the kidney, you won't actually get the answer you're looking for. And there's a very small but real risk of actually seeding the tract of the needle. However, this is very uncommon, so people who do need to get a kidney biopsy for other reasons should be rest assured. If you have a small kidney tumor, less than 2 centimeters in size, you can talk to your urologist about potentially undergoing active surveillance. And what that means is undergoing periodic imaging of the kidney to see if there are changes in size of the kidney mass, rather than proceeding directly to surgery. If you've undergone surgery or been diagnosed with metastatic or advanced kidney cancer, then there are therapeutic options to help prevent the further spread or reduce the spread of the kidney tumor. Lastly, where does kidney cancer spread to? As I mentioned earlier, kidney cancer most often spreads to the lung. However, it can also spread to the bone, brain, liver, and other lymph nodes. Of the people who do not present with metastatic disease, which is again a third of the people who present with kidney cancer, so of the remaining 70%, somewhere between 20 and 40% will go on to develop metastatic kidney cancer. So it's really important that you follow up for imaging even after surgery if you end up having surgery for a kidney cancer. So I hope this answers some of the most common questions about kidney cancer. If you want to learn more about kidney cancer, I'm happy to reach out to some of my colleagues who are experts in treating kidney cancer and can give you a more detailed answer to some of your questions. Please comment below with your questions, and as always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.